Hi, everybody. This week I read We Are the Ship, the story of Negro League Baseball. It is written by Kadir Nelson and it's also illustrated by Kadir Nelson. Copyright 2008. It was published by Hyperion Books for Children. It is 78 pages long, I believe most appropriate for students in the third to sixth grade. And as far as genre goes, I classified it under nonfiction, picture storybook, and cultural diversity. So this book is really an incredible book. It won the Coretta Scott King Award in 2009, and it is the story about the Negro League, the Negro Baseball League. So this chapter book, it introduces its readers to several of the greats in the league. So they're going to learn about Judd Wilson, Oscar Charleston, Buck Leonard. And then they also will learn about Ruby Foster, who is the founder of the league. And then, because I live close to Kansas City, I really enjoyed the part about the Kansas City Monarchs. And so it even talks about the owner, the original owner of the Monarchs, J.L. Wilkinson, and how he really took the Monarchs to the next level. The Monarchs actually played on a level similar to the big leagues. They were the only team in the Negro League to do so, and they actually had the very first night game, which they talk about in this book. So I thought that was really interesting and just really neat. What's also really unique about this book is that the chapters are labeled as innings, and so I thought that was really neat and kind of a fun way to read. And then the illustrations in this book are my favorite of any book that I've read so far this semester. They are paintings, and they are just gorgeous. Let me show you, since we were talking about the Monarchs. So here's an example. All of the illustrations in this book are paintings of players or games or events that actually happened in the Negro Baseball League. So, that was an example of Wilbur Rogan. He played for the Monarchs. But they're just really stunning. Let's see. This is Judy Johnson. I just really, really enjoyed the illustrations. And their paintings are just artwork. There's another one. So I really enjoyed that part. As far as why I believe students should read this book, I really enjoyed reading it. I think it's an excellent read for children for many reasons. First of all, just the format of the book is really appealing. It makes for an easy read and it's fun. I like that the chapters begin as innings, and then they also have a quote at the beginning of each chapter from somebody from the league. And I thought that was really neat. Secondly, the illustrations are just stunning. And I feel like it really makes the stories that are being told come to life for the reader. And then lastly, you know, it's just an important student, it's an important lesson for our students to learn about this part of history. I don't think it's talked about often, but then it also just reminds students to overcome the odds and chase after their dreams. That's an important lesson for me as I'm back in school after almost 15 years of being out to finish my degree. It's always important to chase our dreams and to never give up on ourselves, no matter what adversity we face. As far as an activity that I would have the students do, I actually did this as a student myself. I live close to Kansas City, and so we got to visit the Negro League Museum. And then I would have my students just write a reflection, a couple of paragraphs about what they saw and learned at the museum. So that is it for this week. Thank you.